This year at Sibos, actually in London, there is a few hot topics that have been discussed all over the last 4 days. One of the very pleasing things that I have seen this year, that there's a lot of focus on the FinTechs. We've seen a lot of young companies coming in with transformational solutions to the market and to the banking industry. I see a very nice fusion happening. I see great demand from the banking sector to move forward with their transformational digitalization programs. I think it's a very interesting time to see how this is going to evolve in the next few years and how this amalgamation is going to take place and what's going to actually come out of all this. I think it's going to be a very interesting output for all the stakeholders in this process. What we actually, as Corzap, we are coming to Sibos this year to showcase this solution that we believe is a leapfrog in terms of the Swift GPI compliance. Banks, as I said, are very challenged today with the amount of work that needs to be done. I think by the end of these 4 days, many of the bankers and many of the operation people have come to a great understanding that this needs and requires a lot of resources and a lot of budget and a lot of time. So, and with the deadlines that SWIFT actually has put in place with the confirmations happening in November 2020 as a deadline, I think there is a great burden on most of the banking community today. We are talking about more than 10,000 financial institutions that actually need to comply within the next 12 months, at least with the first level of compliancy for the confirmations. So basically, what Corzap does actually is it speeds the process of bringing these banks into compliance by adopting a full architecture that will plug into their environment and will do all the processes that are required for the Swift GPI in terms of regulation. Not also that, but it will also give the bank full control in terms of their correspondent agreement fees and structures and claims and all the actual physical operational work that is done in the back office today. I may focus much on the long tail, as they say, the small and medium enterprise banks. I see the challenges there are humongous. The bigger banks are much bigger. They have the capacity, they have the resources, they have the big players. But seriously, they only comprise about maybe 2% of the population or the community of the SWIFT. So today we are talking about mostly over 10,000 plus institutions that still have not even started to look at this compliance regulation and how they can actually fit their systems internally. So Corzap is directly targeting all the long tail and the small and medium enterprise banks globally, all over the world. Recently, Corzap, we have actually the evolution of Corzap has been over the last 6-7 years. When we started, actually, the main objective, there was no Swift GPI at the time, but the main objective of this solution was to create a full straight-through processing environment to fully automate the back office operations of Swift. It was a very big challenge for us. We did a lot of great effort in understanding the processes internally that are taking place today. We had to look into the different hazards and problems in terms of collecting all the data in the right time, notifying the stakeholders in the right time, calculating the right fees as per the correspondence, claiming all these operational issues, unfortunately, till today in the mass population of the banks that I'm talking about are done over Excel sheets, maybe over islands of different small softwares that do bits and bobs of many little things, because it's a fragmented sort of environment in the back end. And this is where Corzap actually comes in to bring all these functions under just one roof with a one full solution that will take them from full automation to control to finally Swift GPI compliance. And not only that, but to maintain and sustain that compliance, because you can actually bring a bank to compliance. Maybe it's tough, but you can do it. But to maintain that bank and to sustain the compliance of that bank over a period of time with the volumes growing, I think this is the great challenge that the banks are going to realize after a while, especially that the SWIFT today have created what they call the observer analytics, which basically ranks all the banks based on the criteria of how much adhering are they to the SWIFT GPI regulations. And this is for the first time ever, I think this solution is going to expose all the financial institutions worldwide, across not only to each other but amongst all their clients also. The amount of transparency that is being put into this is seriously something to stand and you know, like give a standing ovation for that, because seriously this is going to change the market for good, forever. And I think it's going to be a great time to see how the banking and the financial institutions finally are going to ride the wave of the new technology and to become the new players of this in the next generation of banking and finance. As I said, of course, apart from the GPI, I think people are starting to realize the importance of the data. We are seeing a lot of AI solutions today. We are looking at business intelligence. I think the banking sector at large has started to realize that the amount of data they are sitting on today is a treasure of information that can very well assist them going forward in trying to better target their customers, or trying to create niche markets for themselves, or to catch opportunities that nobody else can see. So I believe there is going to be a great awareness and openness, especially with the open banking concept and exposing your data outside to the world while securing this data, which is also a very big challenge that the world is being challenged today. And this is one of the topics, of course, on the top of the agenda at SWIFT, the CSP programs, the security program. But at the end of the day, what I'm saying is I think that the trend is already moving forward. Fintechs are actually pulling the banks forward with their new innovations. Banks today are listening. There are over 100 fintechs here today. They've been talking with all people from different sizes of banks. I believe in time, things are actually moving in the right direction. And as I said, the amalgamation and the fusion that is happening today between all these stakeholders, I think will create something very advanced for all of us to come.